Good afternoon, friends. After tea break, everybody is fresh. Good afternoon. Very good. You must be happy today that today is the last lecture. Good. And the subject given to me is assessments and appeal. So till today, you have studied MVAT as well as GST in our coaching class. Now, the last and very important aspect after studying taxes, with compliance, assessment is very important. Because compliance you can do sitting in your office. Your assessment, you have to come here, face the officer, you have to convince him, and you need to do the required activities to convince him. Anybody know what is assessment? Mention over there, but don't see that. What is assessment? What is the meaning of the word assessment? You do not know that what is assessment in CST or VAT. But what is the meaning of the word assessment? Assessment is assessing somebody. So here in VAT, when you are attending assessment, what you are doing? You are attending in front of the officer or your client, and the officer is assessing your client. Assessing your client is assessing your books, assessing his financials, assessing his return filing. See, what he generally does, the returns and audit. See, assessment usually includes scrutiny of. He scrutinizes the things, he checks the things. What he check? He checks the returns and audit report. Turnover, sale and purchases, whatever turnover mentioned by you in your returns and given in your financial, that is in profit and loss account, balance sheet, whatever is there, it's correct, matching or not matching. Commodities sold and proper taxes are levied on the commodities. See, there are different rate of taxes. Now it is in GST, it is 5%, 12%, 18%, whatever in CST tax it was 4 and 5%, previously it was 4% in VAT, then increased to 5%, then 12%, 13%. So, whatever rate you are levied on the goods, it's correct or not? If you are levied 5% on the goods of 13% rate, which is actually applicable, there will be a revenue loss. So, he has to verify that whether you have levied correct rate of tax or not. So, if it is less, he has to demand the balance amount from you. If it is more, the government will recover it, and if possible, they return it to the concerned client, and if not returned, they take it back. Otherwise, it is forfeited, correct. Keep quiet. There is a provision of forfeiture, basically. No, you cannot claim because you have claimed charge more. When you have charged more, instead of 5%, if you have charged 13% to the custom. Collected and paid. But if it is wrong and it is identified at the time of assessment, this is wrong collection. And if you say that if it is wrong collection, then I was liable for 5%, I have paid 13%. So you pay me the difference of 8%. So government will not pay you the 8%, but they will identify the persons from whom you have collected. If it is possible, very few people are there, they will refund it to them or it will be forfeited. Generally forfeited. By the client. Procedure, that means you have to inform to the government, then they will, generally nobody does this, they forbid that. Generally it is forbidden. Then how much tax collected? Tax collected shown is correct as per balance sheet and as per your return. And what is paid? If everything matches, that he has to see. Then input availed, that whatever input availed by you or claimed by you is correct or not. If it is correct, then it's okay. If it is incorrect, then he used to verify it and make the necessary correction. If there is a demand, he used to demand that may reduce the input or increase the input. That is input eligible and taxes paid. So I have covered everything. Assessments are conducted by CST officer, assistant commissioner of CST and deputy commissioner of CST. there are different authorities. If your turnover is less, then sales tax officer used to do your assessment. If your turnover is more, then it goes to assistant commissioner. Or if your refund is more, it goes to assistant commissioner. If your turnover is more than that, that is LTO, it is called, that is big taxpayers. If big taxpayers are there, it goes to deputy commissioner. So these are the authorities who conduct the assessments. Of course, all conduct the assessment on behalf of the commissioner of sales tax. Assessments are of the various types, that is full assessment, refund audits, and issue-based assessment. These are the three important assessment types. There are certain other assessments also, but generally you have to face to these three notices. Full assessment. Full assessment is this. In full assessment includes complete scrutiny of books of accounts, VAT returns, VAT audit report, turnover of sale, turnover of purchases, rate of taxes levied on sales, eligible ITC, input tax credit, ITC disallowed, how much it is disallowed, sometimes ITC, you have to decide how much it is to be reduced or whatever, or you disallow it. The retention is there, retention and reduction of ITC, whether retention, correct retention is taken or not. Declaration forms, received, not received, those declared, what are the declaration forms? C form, H form, I form, E1, etc. Then another type is refund rate. Here also, they used to see all these factors, what they see in full assessment. Only thing, because there is a refund, they call you for the assessment. Because in your return, you have claimed refund, as well as if you have paid 501 to claim refund. So, that is called refund assessment. There was compulsory assessment for all the cases they used to take, right? And procedure is same. Only thing refund is there, then he used to verify whether refund is correct, claimed or not, if it is less or more, accordingly modify the refund. And then he issues the refund. Previously it was 18 months, and now up to 8 years, 10 years, anyway. Generally, to complete the assessment, they have to complete it within 8 years. But they used to send you the notice and keep the assessment open, and they do it after that within 1 year. So 8 to 9 years it takes generally. It is not like that. Now they are completing 13, 14, 14, 15 also. So commissioner has given them time limit. But sometime what happened previously, what happened? There was no time limit. Now there is a time limit. Sorry? They don't have staff. So now what they have done for issue base. So now I have come to issue base. Documents regard to the submitted for the assessment and refund audit. See, just I will come to that report. Now, what are the documents you have to submit? See, I have given you the list of the documents. If you submit the entire list of the documents together, it helps you generally to complete the assessment faster. Because generally, the officer is also interested to do your work, because he is supposed to do your job, because he is sitting there and it is his duty to complete your assessment. So he has to complete your assessment anyhow. So it will be all the papers together, whatever you know. It helps him to verify the papers together simultaneously. थोड़ा 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 करते बैठेंगे तो उसका कभी खत्म नहीं होता है काम, उसका भी खत्म नहीं होगा और आपका भी खत्म नहीं होगा. Every time when you go there, you have to wait for the in queue. So if somebody is there, then he will verify paper, then he will give you the list. Out of the list, if you bring, if he has given 10 items, you next time if you give 5 items, what will happen? Again, he has to wait for 5 items. Then he cannot verify all the things together. If he verify all the things together, it satisfies him. He comes to what is there in the case, and he can complete your assessment faster. It helps you also. Because instead of attending 10 times, you can attend once or twice. You spare more time in your office, sitting and completing the work, instead of going and sitting in the CSTS office. You sit in your office, see the checklist, as per checklist, prepare everything. One of the important thing in the checklist, the person who is attending on behalf of the SSC, the client, dealer, should be authorized person. Either he should be advocate, chartered accountant, or ITP, STP, STP here, STP, or company secretary, ICW, all they are authorized. Same time, if he is an employee of the dealer, he also can attend on behalf of him. So there are certain forms, 708, 709 forms are there. He should give that forms as a letter of authority. It is called letter of authority. He has to put stamp to that letter of authority. Some 5 rupees, 10 rupees fees prescribed for that. MVAT audit report. You have to, if audit is conducted for that dealer, you have to carry the audit report. Income tax audit report also with the MVAT audit report you have to carry. VAT and CST written file copies. At least acknowledgement copies you should carry, because they, when though they say you can see everything in the computer, generally they find it difficult. If you attach the copies, you can verify it there itself and complete assessment. Taxpayer challenge, sale register, sale summary, purchase register, purchase summary. You can carry purchase summary, you have to submit, you have to carry purchase register. Sale and purchase bill file you have to carry with you. Ledger confirmations of top 10 dealers you have to carry with you. Declaration forms against respective CST sales. If there is a CST sales, you have to submit declaration form. With the declaration form, if C form is there, you have to attach a lorry receipt as a proof of transport. If you attach the sale invoice also, it helps you with lorry receipt, sale invoice, and all the figures matching. Then he can accept and allow that C form immediately. It helps him. TDS certificate, if any, if there is cost contract or any other thing, if any TDS is there, you should attach TDS certificate Xerox with that and other documents as required. Then in every case, there are certain different papers required. Sometimes if there is a work contract, you have to attach contract document or like that something. So according to the your nature of dealer, you have to attach any other document if it is required. But with all these documents, these are the basic required documents. So if you go with these documents, your 80% work is over. There itself we can see, and then whatever small list is there, he will give you. In the next hearing, you can complete the assessment. Issue-based audits. What is issue-based audit? When there are certain issues, then only issue-based audit notice is issued to you. That is VAT payable as per Form 704. In your Form 704, if certain amount is shown as a payable, then the issue you notice that this amount is shown as per your 704 and you have not paid that, you have to go with your challenge if it is paid after that, after filing 704, and if it is not paid, you have to pay that with interest whatever and submit it to him. Your assessment will get over because that is for particular issue. He will not go through your, all the books and all other papers. Similar with the CST payable, differential tax liability against the declarations not received. What is differential tax liability? Anybody? If declaring, when you mention in your 704 or when CPOM is received, you charge 2%. Actually, tax rate is 13% or 5%, whatever. So, that is a differential liability. That is 11% is a differential liability that you have to show in your return itself in your 704 that this is not. Form is not received, so this much I have to pay. And after that, if you have received the forms after filing 704, then you have to submit those forms, then you need not have to pay any differential liability. Or on the forms which are not received, you have to pay on those forms only. So you can submit the forms which are not received at that time. Now you can submit the forms. ITC claim from return non-filers, short filers, etc. That is either Hawala, there are written non filers, short filers. What is Hawala? Anybody know what is Hawala? Because in before 5 to 8 years, CSTS department has catch so many people doing Hawala Hawala means they are issuing bills, not paying anything to the government. According to the State Department, those bills are bogus bills. So no revenue is received in the Department Treasury. So you have to pay tax on that. If you have claim any ITC, ITC is input tax credit. If you have claim any input tax credit on the bills issued by these people, because they show taxes, tax amount, net amount, tax amount and total. So you have paid by check or whatever way, and if the bill is of 1 lakh rupees, a net amount 13,000 tax and total is 113. So if you have claimed 13,000 rupees in your input tax credit and government has not received that amount, so government says the amount is not received by us, I will not give you any input tax credit from the purchases of those dealers. So you have to pay that tax. That is same is the case with the short miners. Short miners means the people those whose liability is 10 lakhs, but they buy only one, they have paid only 1 lakh to the government, balance amount is not yet paid. Though they have shown their correct liability and everything, but amount is not paid. So even in that case, government has not received any amount, so you have to pay tax on that. If you, that is there on the website. All these Hawala list and everything is there on the website. So you can find out from that list. Same case. But cancelled, if your number is cancelled before issuing invoice to you, then you are in problem. But number is cancelled after issuing invoice to you, and if he has paid taxes, then you are not concerned with that. Exactly, in that case, that is short file. If he has issued invoice, declare that in the return also, but he don't have money to pay taxes. So taxes are not paid. He is a genuine dealer, he will pay tax to the government whenever he receive money, but till the assessment taxes are not paid. In that case, government will not give you input tax credit, they will disallow your input tax credit, and on that disallowance even they will charge you interest also on that demand. But in future, if he pays those taxes, and if you come to know if that person has paid, because substantial amount is there, and that person has paid taxes to the government, so you can claim that amount as a refund from the government. Till today, I think nobody has claimed that, but that provision is there. From the your dealer only. From that person, you will come to know whether he has paid or not, because you will do required follow-up, because your money has gone. So if it is there, if you prove that this person has paid entire amount and you disallowed my input tax credit because he was short filer, so you get your money back. Because government will not collect from both dealers. They will not allow you, sir. That is 485 section is there. Accordingly, they have made those provisions, and that is also not wrong. When money is not received in government treasury, how they can give you input tax credit? If they are not received, they will not allow you. Because see, it is treated as good as they have not paid. That means what? You have not paid. Because your input is disallowed, that means you have not paid. So accordingly, demand increases and there is a demand for that amount, and that you have to pay interest from that year till today, till the completion of assessment. So these specific issue-based cases, these assessment completes after submission of the concerned documents, only specific documents you are required to submit.
Sir, in case of issue-based audit, if it is only due to audit report, the tax demand for the audit report, do they issue assessment orders?
Now they are issuing. Previously they were not issuing the orders, they were closing it themselves. I'm getting, that is wrong.
Because if interest is not paid, in one of my cases, interest is interest, so on what
total in those cases when there is a demand, they issue orders. Okay. If there is no demand, near demand, if you are very genuine person, if you have made interest with taxes and if you get everything, there is no demand, then you will not issue. But if there is demand, he will issue demand notice.
Can we get some benefit in terms of interest officially from the officer or the appellate authority?
No, that is not. Previously it was there, long back in sales tax it was there. Now, in interest, no benefit is permissible. In penalties, can be considered in appeal. After submission, see, before submission they will issue, and after submission they will not. Sometimes they issue order, some previously they were not issuing orders. Issue this order. When now they are issuing orders, because now we have made the representation to the commissioner and everything. Now they are issuing order. Previously they were closing on the proceeding itself. So actually collecting order is good because you have some proof that you have attended. Even in my case, recently, previously issue based audit was there. We have submitted all the forms to the concerned deputy commissioner. Even we have taken acknowledgement of the same. Then full assessment came. We have submitted letter of that letter stating that we have submitted these forms. And copy of the forms are also given in the assessment. Officer writes in the assessment, he has given demand of 1 crore 4 lakhs and all. Only because forms not received. Because we were not having any order, because he has closed there itself in the proceeding. Then we went there, find out the file, and sent that file to the officer. But by that time he has completed the assessment. Not considered. मेरे पास form नहीं है, मैं क्या करूँ? Actually that is wrong. See, then we now I have collected order. In these type of cases, we should go to the commissioner and give the complaint form, officer. Because it is his duty to find out the file. It is not my duty. When I have given submitted the forms and I have acknowledgement of the same. And that is produced, not only produced. In the letter we have mentioned that this thing has been produced and acknowledgement has been taken from the concerned officer also. That acknowledgement is also with us. And after that, yes, pass order stating that forms are not received. Otherwise, he should have mentioned in the order that he says that forms filed with the so and so officer and I have not received it. Whatever. Whatever he has to mention, he has not mentioned anything, just mentioned that forms not received. So, then you should go to commissioner. If you are submitting documents, that means like C form and everything. See, Xerox copies are submitted, so it's okay, you can submit it again. But as far as possible, you should ask for the, because commissioner has given circular also in that case. That you should give acknowledgement for everything. You should immediately go. If he is assistant commissioner, go to deputy commissioner, it's in charge officer immediately, or JC, and submit the papers over there. Don't submit here. Or ask him to give him a, he will call the concerned officer and he will get assessment all day. Acknowledging. It is there on the website also. Last year circular, right? 2016. Last year circular is there. So, but it is available. And see, exactly, that is the reason you should ask for the acknowledgement. Not only that, ask the acknowledgement with the stamp. Sometimes what they do, just mention signature karta hai, date dalta hai, chhod deta hai. So kiska sign hai, wo aadmi nahi samajhta hai. So take the, because that rubber stamp is very important. So take acknowledgement with the rubber stamp. Means is that very politely you can tell him, because even we, अरे थोड़ा सा आप क्या आप किधर जाने वाले हैं, हम किधर जाने वाले हैं, किधर कोई नहीं जाता है. स्टैंडर्ड आंसर. तो यू शुड पोलाइटली सेम सी वी हैव फेस प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एंड दैट इज द ओनली रीजन वी आर आस्किंग फॉर द एक्नॉलेजमेंट बिकॉज आफ्टर दैट नोबडी कम्स टू हेल्प यू बिकॉज व्हेन यू कंप्लेन that I have submitted papers and not given. So no, you don't have any excuse. This type of excuses nobody is ready to hear. At the most, as a courtesy, they will ask that officer to find out the file. That is, if everything is on merit, actually it is, it is his duty to send the order by checking the document, whatever you have submitted. But if we pass the order without demand, then it's okay. They are so good, they are passing the order with huge demand without informing you. And now in issue-based cases, they have even started saying that only one assessment, one hearing for issue-based, single hearing. They don't give more than one hearing. So whatever papers you want to carry, you have to carry at a time. If you are ready to fight with them, you can say that right on my letter, I will come next time. But it is also not possible every time. Anyway, so section 23 provides various type of assessments and the time limit within which the assessment to be completed. So all our assessments are done under section 23 by the concerned officers. There are 1 to 11 sections in section 23, where 23.1, here they do the assessment if he is a registered dealer and fails to file the return within the prescribed time. 23.2, return is filed by the registered dealer by the prescribed time. So they have made different provisions that first is if returns not filed at all or returns filed late, returns, all returns filed and everything is correct, even then they can call for the assessment. So that is 23.2. Then 23.2A. See, this issue is, this is 23.2 is full assessment generally. And 23.6 is issue based assessment. Generally we get these two notices only. All other provisions are there, but in these two provisions you get notices on 23.3A or all. So all these provisions are there where you get notices for assessment as well as under which they pass the order. This 23.6 says the commission is of the opinion that in respect of any period covered by the return, only turnover of sale or purchase is not disclosed or tax is paid at a lesser rate, set off has been wrongly claimed or deduction has been wrongly claimed. So if we feel there is some mistake in the return or for different reasons we feel that set off is wrongly claimed, taxes are wrongly paid, they will call you, that is for that particular issue. So up to 23.13 provisions are there where they can pass order of assessment. Acha, what you should do? What you should do at the time of assessment when you are going to attend the assessment? What are the required things you want to compulsorily do? That is, you should go with a written submission or letter stating that following things I have brought. It start, that checklist I have given you previously. It start with letter of authority, protein of account, balance sheet, audit report, income tax audit report, this thing, that thing, C forms. If you are submitting C form, specify in your letter that 13 C form, 14 C form or 50 C form, whatever you are submitting, amounting to is this. Clearly specify that. Where list is enclosed with this letter. So enclose the list, specify the details of the C form in the list on the first page of the letter, clearly mention that these number of C forms are enclosed and amount is this. So if they misplace the file or anything goes wrong, you will have a right to see that, say that this much amount I have already submitted. Because they don't sign at two places. Either they will sign on the main page of the letter or on the list of the C form. So if he signs on the list of the C form, you will not get the acknowledgement of the whatever written first. So specifically mention that and say and specify that original and bold, make bold original C forms 23, 50, whatever submitted amounting to this. Make that very bold. Sometimes we ask the officer to write above its signature received original CPOMs. It helps you. Try to take signature of the officer on the CPOM and all other cases instead of its clerk or pune. Don't take signature of pune at all because he is not responsible. Then you should carry that written submission, your letter, everything. Proceeding sheet, then when you submit all these papers, he verify the papers, auto verifying the papers, he in his proceeding sheet he specify that Mr. So and so attended, your designation also he specify, and whatever you have submitted, some officers mention or some user mention in the proceeding that as per his letter dated so and so, papers are submitted, and following papers are valid which are not submitted, so he gives you next hearing for the balance paper. So you should read whatever he is writing, read it carefully. And then only if you read it carefully and sign it. Don't just because they mark there, sign here. You just sign it there, and if you specify in your order certain thing that you have accepted these, you have not paid this, or you have accepted these, whatever. Mentioned in the proceeding sheet and signed by you is considered as you have accepted that. So in appeal, if you have to file appeal against something, against that order, it will create problem because he will say in his order that he has accepted this much penalty, he has accepted this interest. So you will not be able to file appeal or say it as your grievance. Don't have the copy, but you can read at that time when you are signing.
But if the
generally you have right to verify the papers. Entire file can be verified by you by giving letter and paying certain attaching court fee stamp to that. No, not through RTA also, even in Sessions law there is a provision to verify the file. So you can verify the entire file, no problem. Even if you want copy of that, certain papers, you can ask for the copies. Not necessary. See, if you mention wrong in the order, if he pass ex parte, that is ex parte order, if he pass ex parte order, even after attending you, so you have some acknowledgement with you, even if he misplaced his proceeding, then whatever you say, if it happens, his proceeding is misplaced by mistake or intentionally, whatever. And if he prepare a fresh proceeding and he be mentioned in that you are not attended at all, and if you don't have your previous record, so you can show that acknowledgement, then your case will be remanded back. It will be sent back to the concerned officer by appellate authority. If you will be having acknowledgement of whatever submitted, or you attend without any paper. So that acknowledgement, that is the reason I told you initially, you should keep acknowledgement of everything. That is very important, because that helps you everywhere. If you have acknowledgement, it's stamped and signed by the officer. You can say, when this acknowledgement is there, that means you attended, or at least papers are submitted. Inspection of that is called inspection of record. You ask inspection of record is permissible. You can take inspection anytime when you feel you require to see the file. So up to here, assessment proceedings are complete. You have to complete it by 4:34:45. So it will complete. Don't worry. See, I have taken this little elaborately. I have not gone into the sections very much, but I have given you the practical aspect of the assessment, which is very important, because otherwise, I don't say anything, but I have seen few lectures where all sections are elaborately discussed. So discussion sections elaborately is important, but practical aspect, because now you can read the sections, you know, And this type of assessment will be there even in GST. Nothing more. Because you have to attend with the paper, this thing, that thing. Now only in GST there will not be no document. CPAM, where you have to carry your challenge, you have to like that, all these things will be there if there is the assessment. Assessment will be very less, but if there is the assessment, all these things will be there. Now, appeals. Why you are filing appeal or what is appeal? What do you mean by appeal? The word, meaning of the word appeal? Not agreeing with them. So what is the meaning of the word appeal? Dictionary meaning of the word appeal. So it is a type of request. Or you are appealing somebody, stating that there is a grievance. So give me justice. The appeal is for the justice. So why you are appealing? Because you are not satisfied with the order. You are an aggrieved party. The order passed by the concerned assessing officer. There are some either dispute, you can say, or some aggression, or some. You are not agreeing with everything what he has passed. So you want some relief from the higher authorities. That is appeal. So appeal is filed with whom? See, section and everything is given there. Section 26 of the MVAT Act, you can file appeal, then like that. So you can read it. I think we are sending you. Mail by mail, they are sending it to you. As you read it, very good. So, appeal is filed with whom? With the higher authority, not with the officer of the same rank. So, if your assessment is done by the STO, sales tax officer, appeal is filed with Deputy Commissioner of Sales Tax. You have to submit appeal within 60 days. Form to file appeal is 310. In that particular form, you have to file appeal. If assessment is done by Deputy Commissioner, there is higher authority, Joint Commissioner. So you can file appeal with Joint Commissioner appeals. Here there are two different Deputy Commissioner as well as Joint Commissioner. In Deputy Commissioner, there are Deputy Commissioner Assessment, Deputy Commissioner Administration, Deputy Commissioner Appeals. So the Deputy Commissioner appeals, you have to file your appeal. That is also specified in your demand notice with whom you can file appeal. That is there mentioned in your order. So you can go to the concerned officer and file your appeal. You have to file appeal within 60 days from the date of receipt of the order, not from the date of order. Date of receipt of the order, but you have to, when you receive order, you have to put the date on the order as well as on the acknowledgement, you have to put the date. Then only you can say that this is the date of receipt of the order. Then, if order is passed by the Deputy Commissioner, you can file appeal with Joint Commissioner. Time limit is same. Joint Commissioner, see, these are the two, there are first appeal and second appeal. These are called the first appeal. The order is passed by the assessing authority. So, first appeal is filed before Deputy Commissioner or Joint Commissioner. Accordingly, after passing your second appeal is filed with the tribunal. If even after filing appeal with the Deputy Commissioner or Joint Commissioner, if you are not satisfied with the results, if you are still aggrieved, you feel that you have not received justice, so you can file your appeal with the tribunal. Tribunal is the last fact finding authority. Here in tribunal you can give the details of the facts. These were the facts, CPOM is not received. You can even submit CPOM in tribunal. If it still it is pending, finally you can submit it with tribunal, because there you get sufficient time, because it comes to hearing after certain years and like that. So here also you get 60 days time, and that is the last fact finding authority. Two judges are sitting over there, that is called tribunal members. One is judicial member, one is revenue. So two members are there and they are giving you decision. Then last, finally is High Court, then Supreme Court. So in High Court, tribunal, if you are still, if you feel that you have not got justice, from the order of the tribunal, he can file appeal in High Court. That is within 120 days from the date of receipt of the order. Only when there is a question of law. And there is a substantial question of law. Otherwise, that is not a fact finding authority. They will not admit. Similarly, in Supreme Court, when there is a question of law, he can go to Supreme Court or to High Court. Which are the forms or documents required? Form 310 for MVAT appeal, Form 9B for CST appeal, grounds of appeal, and prayers. You have to mention in your grounds of appeal why you are filing appeal, what you are aggrieved, or where you feel that you are not received justice. So you have to specify that these are the grounds of appeal, and this is the reason I am filing them. What is grounds of appeal? Your contention. Your grievances, your contention stating that I should get this, and this is the correct way assessment should be done, and the concerned officer has not accepted this. And prayer. Prayer means what? What you expect from the officer with whom you are filing appeal. That your assessment should be passed like this, and demand should be reduced, interest should be removed, and why it is removed. Form 311, that is application for stay and dismissal. Generally, when orders are passed, either ex parte order or another order, there are demands. Sometimes there is a refund, even then you feel that you need to file appeal for different reasons, certain issues, though there is a refund. But 98% cases there is a demand in the order and you are filing appeal. So demand in assessment order or what? You require a stay because you feel that that order is wrong. You will get justice from the higher authority. So the demand is wrong. That is the reason you are filing it. And if the demand is recovered, because you have to pay the demand within 30 days from the date of order or from the date of receipt of the order at the most. So if they recover that, they have power to recover that. So you have to file form 3113 311 bharna padega aapko, stating that you stay that recovery. So then you have to attach original assessment order. Not xeroscopic of assessment order, you have to attach original assessment order, letter of authority, that is form 708 or 9, appeal filing fees you have to pay, that is whatever fees is there, 1000 rupees or 0.5% what is there. Then letter for condemnation of delay, in case brief letter is filed late, after 60 days from the date of receipt of the order, you have to file letter for condemnation of the delay. So these are the documents you require at the time of filing of appeal. Powers of appellate authority, what they can do? They can confirm the demand and the previous order. They can reduce, enhance or cancel. If penalty is there, he can reduce it, enhance it also. He feels that not properly mind is applied by the officer, he can increase it also. Or he can cancel it, totally remove it. That depends how you plead your case and what your contention is genuine or it is on merit or what. That is what I told you. In appeal against order imposing penalty, the appellate authority may confirm, cancel the order or modify it. In any other case, the appellate authority may pass such order in appeal as it deemed fit. Sometime in appeal, he can go through each and everything. If he feels that officer has not seen certain things and it is required to verify in this appeal, he can see, not necessarily, it is not binding on him that he should see whatever you see, say in your contention. He can see anything of that assessment here. About stay, I have told you, you have to, in 311, you file that form. He will give you stay subject to certain conditions. What are the conditions? That is, you have to pay certain part payment, or sometimes on nil part payment also they give you stay if it is on merit. If you feel that really huge injustice has been done in this case, or some wrong conclusion has been taken by the officer, he can give you nil part payment also. Or generally 25%, 50% part payment will be asked, depending on the merit of the case. So when you pay that much part payment, then they will give stay for the balance part, balance payment. Ten percent, you know, to pay with the. But that is 10% only, no? Now, as per new amendment, you have to pay 10%.
10% of the disputed amount. Is that
thing something
that
you get percentage of that? 10% of the disputed amount. That means in your order, two or three different issues are there. And you have to file appeal on a particular issue. And balance two you have accepted. So there is demand of 10 lakhs rupees. Where two you are accepting, which is of 3 or 4 lakhs you have accepted and 7 lakhs is in dispute. So if you mention that on the disputed amount, that you have to pay 70,000, no, 7 lakhs. Sorry, how much?
10%.
10%. On 70,000 you have to pay 10%, that is 7,000 rupees. If it is 1 lakh, 7,000. If it is 10 lakhs, 70,000 rupees. So whatever 10% you have to pay on the disputed amount. Even when there is a dispute or appeal for a C form or any bonds, there you have to pay the entire tax amount of the bonds not received. Then only they accept your appeal if it is more than 2 years from the date of your that financial year. So bonds are not received. That means generally it is more than 2 years only. If bonds are not received, you have to pay tax amount at least, not interest amount of that bond. And if you receive those bonds till the hearing of that appeal, you will get that amount back also. They will refund. Assessment in GST. Similar proceedings are there, different sections are there. Which sections are mentioned? But they are specified in the Act. So that is the reason I am just giving you some hints are given, yet to come, but it will come. So it is you should actually know more about GST than the previous law, but still you should know about the previous law because still assessments are there and those assessments will continue for the next 2 to 3 years. So we have taken both. So about GST you should, that is the reason. Practical, I have not attended any assessment in GST. So practical issues I cannot discuss on that, but these are the provisions made in the Act. So, but see, always similar provisions are there. Assessment means they have to verify your taxability, your returns, your paper, and they have to verify that whether it is matching with your financials. If it is not matching, they will make a demand. So if taxes are paid less, the same thing they have to see. See, generally in GST it is expected that there will be assessment because tax payment and everything compliance will be compulsory in GST. It will be there. If you not comply, they will send you notice immediately. So that cannot be called as an assessment, but it is notice for certain issues, not filing of it and this thing, that thing. So that will be there. Small assessment or this thing will not be there because everything they will match with your supplier and everything. So your purchaser and sales both will be matched with your supplier and customer. So there is no need of assessment, and accordingly payment is made, returns will be filed automatically, tax ledger will be there. So assessment will reduce to a great extent. Everything is automatic, system design and divide. So no assessment, only assessment will take place for the rate of tax. Basically, failure of the system. Not possible. That is not that. Playing with the system is not possible. though we are in India, we have a habit of living with everything. But here it is not possible. If we see in income tax also, now that proper system is working for income tax, even you are getting refund after filing this last assessment year you can file. In July and September, refund started. So that system is working good now. So even this system will work good. See, there is a lot of pressure on the GST system than income tax system. Out of 125 crore people, only 3 crores are paying taxes. और इधर उससे ज्यादा बहुत कितना लोग टैक्स भर रहा है, कितना इनवॉइस बन रहा है, क्या क्या हो रहा है. सो देयर इज ह्यूज प्रेशर ऑन द सिस्टम एंड इफ दिस सिस्टम वर्क्स प्रॉपरली दिस विल बी अ मिरेकल इन द वर्ल्ड. इट इज लाइक दैट पीपल विल कम टू सी दिस सिस्टम बिकॉज दिस मच पॉपुलेशन इज देयर एंड दिस मच ट्रांजेक्शन आर देयर एंड एवरी ट्रांजेक्शन इज विल बी मैच विद अदर ट्रांजेक्शन. सी वी आर जस्ट शाउटिंग स्टेटिंग दैट इज इट इज नॉट वर्किंग बिकॉज वी हैव प्रॉब्लम. So, but it is really a great job they are doing. We are facing problems, so we are shouting because we are not worried what they are doing. But they are doing a great job. If it continues, it will help everybody other than the professionals. Then there will be no lectures. Our requirement will automatically reduce because system will do everything. And you have to attend only for the rate of tax and all these type of legal disputes. For even for that they have made provision of advance ruling, which was not there in sales tax. Here, what you have to do before starting a business, you can go to the government and ask them, "This is my product. Tell me the rate of tax." So whatever rate of tax given by them at that time, they cannot modify it or reduce it or increase it. That is binding on them. So you need not have to worry. After 15 years or 10 years, at the time of assessment, the officer find out that your rate of tax was not 5%, it is 13%. Vodafone का case में कुछ हुआ था. हाँ, just like DDP or even. So if they find out like something this is wrong, this is right. So you have to pay the entire tax for the previous period. That you need not have to worry for that. You can decide your liabilities will be fixed. When they have declared that this is your rate of tax, you can pay that much and you will be free. So all these new things they have introduced, when this system will work good, certainly things will move better. Assessment of non-federal returns, see all this last year. See, that 50% or 20-25% were that tables are copied from her notes only. But remaining is mine. All these tables, and it was actually it was not in the form of table, it was in a different form, in the text form. Because we have made it PPT, we have made it in table form, made it different. And उसको ऊपर नीचे क्या मेरा है. See, authority on the act. So she has taken it more. She has elaborated sections and everything more. She has explained these things in detail. I have explained you practical aspect of the assessment. So now you are expert in both. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. All the best.